我们生在今天这个时代，我们就应该在今天的时代来做神、做学问、做事业。
Going through the change of a dynasty, experiencing the war brutality, and living in an era of declining interest in Confucianism, he not only wrote books, but also taught and ran a school to promote how to become a modern Chinese scholar. He was the last master of traditional Chinese intellectuals, as well as a great self-taught contemporary Confucian scholar, Qian Mu. Qian Mu, art name Bin Si, was born in Wuxi, Jiangsu, China in 1895. He was intelligent and fond of learning from a young age. In 1911, revolution broke out and classes were suspended. Qian Mu, whose family was poor, started teaching in a high school. With only a high school education, Qian Mu became a scholar specializing in history, classic Chinese literature, and cultural and intellectual history through self-education.
前先的学术上的创建啊，一定要放在中国现代史的这个框架中间来理解。民国初年的时候，人们对整个时代背景的失望，所以整个二十世纪的中国是一个反传统的世纪。
While facing the trend toward rejection of tradition, Qian Mu chose to answer the common questions through study, writing, and teaching.He left behind over 80 resounding masterpieces, and these works contained over 17.5 million characters. He can certainly be described as a prolific writer.
他最有名的书是《先秦诸子系年》，是一个考据式的著作，影响重大。那另外他有一部著作让他变成中国知名的人物，就是一篇长的论文，叫做《刘向新父子年谱》。这篇文章完全地否定了康有为所有的论据。
The Chronological Life of Liu Xiangxin was published in 1930. In 1931, Qian Mu entered the academic world. He was appointed as a history professor at Peking University. He was also granted the accolade of Hu Shi in the north and Qian Mu in the south.
到了康时期，他的人生最重要的一部著作就是《国史大纲》。而《国史大纲》伴随着这个引论这一篇合刊出来之后，对抗战时期的年轻学子以及他们对中国未来的信心，算是一个很大的鼓舞。
In 1949, the Chinese Civil War broke out, and the KMT retreated to Taiwan. Qian fled to Hong Kong. To provide education to the exiled students, he became the president of New Asia College.With three borrowed classrooms and never give up spirit, he founded the New Asia College. The school's performance was exceptional.
他在香港时期，他开始回头去碰触宋明理学问题。他开始着手写一个五巨册的朱子心学案。他的朱子心学案其实是为未来而写的。
After Qian Mu resigned from New Asia College,He rented a hillside house in Hong Kong's Sha Tin District and engaged in writing. However, the situation in Hong Kong was turbulent. Qian Mu believed a new biography of Zhu Xi's academic life could only be completed in a place where Chinese people lived. He declined an invitation from a U.S. university and moved to Taiwan with his wife.
到台湾来了以后，他有40万，他希望在这附近盖房子，靠近故宫。阳明山管理局的局长姓施，施先生就找到说，哎呀，有一个废弃的墓地，就是这里，因为便宜，去申请人民公证来盖这个房子，正要动工，蒋介石先生知道了，他说你是贵宾，我们该接待你，然后蒋经国先生去管吧，由他负责。那个时候钱思母已经把图样画好了。
In 1967, the KMT government helped Qian Mu build the residence he lived in during his later years. He named the place the Su Shu House and continued his writing and teaching here.
住宿楼主要是因为前些年轻的时候有一次生病，然后他妈妈就在住。